We're gonna take a look here at the Wallball GHD sit-up. Okay, first thing we want to talk about is just the basics of the GHD sit-up, because it's still what it is, all right? It's still the basics behind this movement. You can see what she sets up. Trunk's an extension, knees are slightly bent, all right? Just like you would set up in a regular GHD sit-up. She's gonna grab the ball, okay? What we've done here is we've lifted the target up a little bit, and this can be based on a number of different reasons, whether it be, you know, her level as she comes into CrossFit and whether she's prepared to go all the way down to the ground or not, body length, how high the GHD is, all these different things, okay? The main thing I want to look at as she goes back, number one, is that she keeps a bent knee on the way back, okay? And then as I travel down here, I want to make sure that she's not in super hyperextension. Just like any GHD sit-up, you're going to find a slight hyperextension here, and she needs to be able to hold on to ab engagement, right? She needs to be really strong right here, okay? And then when she comes up, straightens the knee, throws her 6-pound ball to an 8-foot target.
Anything until I got back on the GHD. Like, I didn't realize how taxed my legs were. It's like, you know, you kind of go, I don't know, go somewhere when you're doing the wall balls. I was just concentrating so hard on making sure that I caught it and didn't lose form or anything like that. And so once that was over with and I went back to the GHD, I'm like, oh man, I could feel myself. Like, that was the point at which I knew I had to be really careful getting back on the GHD and, you know, keeping things really tight, because my legs were so tired, so. There was one time, I think, where I tried to catch it and go straight back into the squat, and I fell forward. So for me, even though that, you know, after I caught it, it was just kind of a slam, it was easier for me mentally to prepare for that next set. To just stop and kind of gain composure, because had I lost it, I feel like I wouldn't have gotten to the target, or I would have fallen over and it would have been a missed rep, whereas just kind of keeping a steady pace, something I could count on and keep repeating, you know, was a better game for me. I think it was mentally tougher than it was physically. I mean, physically it was tasking, but certainly there are CrossFit workouts that are more taxing than that. I think the mental aspect came in. I just didn't want to lose the ball in the GHD. Like, I had to really think about everything that I was doing this time. So that in and of itself was enough to make this workout tough.
That's a 3-rep PR.
That's a triple.
I'm going to my own games.